Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to another video on ForgottenWeapons.com. I'm Ian McCollum, and I'm here today at the Rock Island Auction Company taking a look at a Lithuanian Browning High Power. Lithuania is, first off, a country that got pretty royally screwed through most of the 20th century, and they're also one of the countries that was one of the very first purchasers of the Browning High Power from FN. So, a little bit of background on these. Lithuania got its independence in 1918 with the end of World War I and the collapse of the Russian Empire. And there was a brief revival of Lithuanian nationality, really, which included military rearmament, or some attempts at military rearmament, between 1918 and 1940. Of course, in 1940, they got screwed again, occupied by both the Soviet Union and Nazi Germany. And they would end up in the under Soviet domination until about 1990. So there's this little brief window of time, about 20 years, when Lithuania had an independent military, or mostly independent military, and decided to try to rearm. So if you're in that position, one of the major companies at the time that's selling high-end, modern, high-quality military arms is FN. And if you're looking for a modern pistol, in the 1930s, it doesn't get much more modern than the Browning High Power. You've got a 13-round capacity, 9mm caliber, well-built, well-thought-out, fantastic gun. So let's take a look at the few little items that make the Lithuanian purchase unique. Alrighty, so what we have here is a really good example of an early pre-war Browning High Power. And obviously the most distinctive thing on it is this funky symbol. That is the Pillars of Gediminas. It is a rather distinctively Lithuanian symbol that goes back to apparently about the 1300s. So it's just the sort of thing that you would expect a newly independent nation to kind of pick up on as a good symbol of their independence and their own unique culture. These pistols were ordered between 1935 and 1937, and so they have tangent rear sights on them. Now, the very first FN High Powers had 1,000-meter rear sights, and that was a little ludicrous, and so they pretty quickly dropped that to 500 meters. However, the initial 500-meter sights were, the whole 500 meters were in about the first half of the sight, because they didn't change it that much from the 1,000. Eventually, actually still relatively quickly, they would change that to a sight that used the full length of the tangent blade to get to 500 meters by milling a different mounting base into the slides. So that's what all of the Lithuanian guns have. You go out to 500 meters on your rear sight, and you would do that in conjunction with a detachable shoulder stock. However, Lithuania did not order shoulder stocks with the pistols, so you won't find them as matched pairs like you would with, for example, Belgian high powers. You can also see this lanyard staple down here, or lanyard loop, that is unique to the Lithuanian guns. They specifically requested that feature in the order. We have standard FN markings here on the left side of the slide and frame. You got Belgian proofs on both, and then Browning's standard, FN's manufacturer mark and Browning's patent. On the right side, we have the same Belgian proof marks on the barrel, and then serial numbers on slide and barrel. Lithuania ordered 5,000 guns, so they have a serial number range of 1 to 5,000. FN would, during this period, FN's serial number ranges were reset for each individual contract. Now, there are a couple other little features that I can show you on the inside of the gun. So if we lock that open, this disassembles just like a regular, any other high power. Take this off. And there are a couple of proof marks inside the gun. One on the barrel, one on the recoil spring guide. And you'll notice those are also that same Pillars of Gediminas logo, or symbol. It was also used as a proof mark on the inside of the magazine floor plate. And it's almost microscopic there, but that is another Pillars of Gediminas. Also note that the unlocking cam right here in the barrel is rounded. It wouldn't be very long after this that FN would change from a rounded to a square profile in that locking lug. Well, if you collect Lithuanian firearms, this sort of thing is obviously a no-brainer. It's one of the few really distinctively Lithuanian mass production firearms out there. However, there are also people who collect Browning High Powers, and they're kind of like Mausers in that most of the guns are relatively similar to each other, but it's that national crest and a few of the little distinctive elements that I think give a real flavor to the specific history behind each of these small independent orders from different parts of the world. So I think they're pretty cool. If you'd like to have this one, you can check it out in Rock Island's catalog, their most recent auction catalog. They have a write-up on it there with some good pictures. You can check it out online. You can also take a look at Rock Island's Instagram page and their YouTube channel. I have both of those linked in the description text below. Thanks for watching.